Hi guys, MOT here and welcome to another video. In this video, I'll show you guys how you can go from 3G to 4G on your Android device. So the first thing would be to determine if you're connected to a 3G or 4G connection. If you guys see the signal bar right here, it doesn't really tell me if it's connected to 3G or 4G. And in case you guys do have data connection, what you can do is disable your Wi-Fi and connect to data. And in case you see an H plus sign, it means that you're connected to a 3G network. Now in case it was 4G or LTE instead of H or H plus, it would mean that you're connected to a 4G network. Another alternative option that you guys have is to install an app called Netmonster from the Play Store. And what this app does is that it shows you what network you're connected to, the type of connection, the type of technology, and the signal band as well. There are some interesting values as well using this app, and I'm not aware what they exactly mean, but the RSCP refers to the signal strength. So as you guys see, right now I'm connected to Telus Mobility 3G, and the technology is HSPA+, and my frequency for the connection is 1900 megahertz. And it can change from time to time depending on which cell tower I am connected to. The app does have some additional features as well, like graphs, and you can actually see what additional bands you are connected to. And it looks like it switched from one to another, and you can see that in real time. There's also a map functionality, which can show towers in your location. It's not working in my area, but it's supposed to. And then there is logging as well, like what networks I was connected to yesterday and today. Now that we know that we are currently connected to a 3G connection, what we will do is we will go in settings, and from settings we'll go to SIM card and mobile networks. And in certain phones, you will have a setting called as dual 4G. You will need to enable that. You can keep it disabled if you know that the SIM card you have is in the 4G slot. But in some phones, especially if they're dual SIM, only one slot is 4G and the other one is 3G. If you're not sure which slot you put in on a dual 4G phone, then you'll need to enable it. So I've just did it, and then you'll go into SIM card settings, go in preferred network types, and from preferred 3G, you will select preferred 4G. Let's make sure that it was selected. No, okay. And now it's, yeah. You have to give it like a few seconds before the network connects to the other one. And now in case I go to the app again, and as you guys can see, now it's connected to the 4G LTEA 850 band, and it's plus AWS, and then it tells me the signal strength as well. So the other option that you guys have is like just enable your data. And now on the top of my phone, I see it's 4G. In case you did not see the option to change LTE under your SIM card settings, what you can do is you can actually go into your dialer and type in *#*#. 4636#*#*, and that will take you to a phone info option. And let's say if you have a dual SIM, then you'll have to select which slot you want to be on 4G. Let's say if I have phone 1. And in my case, I've set it to LTE already. And you have like multiple options you can choose from. In case you do not know which network your phone connects to, you can select to global auto, but otherwise just keep it on LTE UMTS or LTE GSM and see if it works for you. You may even try some other options out here as well, like LTE / WCDMA, and it all just depends on which network you are on. In case you have doubt, you can always do a search on what network your service works on, or you can even contact customer support regarding that. One thing to make sure is that once you change your network from 3G to 4G, you should enable data and do a ping test to see if your data works or not. Or you can actually open up your browser as well and just go on, let's say, some website and see if everything is good. Since you don't want your data to get disabled out. Another thing is, in certain phones, you have to enable Volt as well. And I recommend you guys to enable it because then you can talk and use data at the same time. Otherwise, whenever you receive a phone call, it will switch from 4G to 3G, or it will try to do that. Or in certain cases, only one of them will work. So I recommend you guys to enable Volt, especially if you want data and calling at the same time. So when you do *#*#, 4636 *#*#, you have to enable Volt provisioned. In case you cannot select that option, it's because your network does not support it, and that's fine. But in case your network supports it, you can turn it to on. Thank you for watching this video. And if you guys have any kind of issues changing from 3G to 4G, just let me know through comments and I'll be able to help you. Don't forget to mention which phone you have, because sometimes these settings are different and things work out differently. Thank you for watching and goodbye.